Well, that was messed up. My camera stopped working for a sec there. Alright. Hello, and welcome to Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. My name is Brendan. This is my show. How are y'all doing? Erica? Stevie. All right. That's good. I'm glad you guys are good. So today I decided to... I'm good, man. Thanks. Fun time in the chat, right? So today, I decided that I am going to stop being a slacker and I'm going to finish the short story that I've been working on stream. It's getting there. It's coming along. So much so, let's flip my main screen here. Oh god, there we go. Man, everything's been a little weird today with OBS. I'm not sure why, but yeah, it's been coming along very well. What's the date today? Today is the 11th. Yeah. So today's the 11th, next week's the 18th, the week after 25th. Right. So, I am going to be off the week of the 25th. So I'm going to be streaming probably all week. So look forward to that, for one. And B, I'd like to finish this short story this week and next week so that on the 25th, I can kind of chow down over the course of a week and just get something done. See what I can do. Taking some inspiration from my good friend John Derek Murphy in that regard where, you know, just want to see how far I can push myself in a week sort of thing with a new story. That's pretty crazy, Erica. I wish I could do that. I don't have a lot of time, unfortunately. I'm also a very slow writer, in my opinion. I don't write a ton of words, but it takes me longer to write those words. That being said, I do a lot less weird editing and stuff, so maybe that's just process, right? I feel like I did something weird in this scene. Oh, totally, man. I used to be a total seat by the pants guy, and I found that I floundered a lot, where I would write the things that I knew, and then I would just stop. I would grind to a sharp halt sort of thing. So I found that even though it's not super natural to me, I really need to, A, do outlines, even basic ones. Like, they don't have to be super complicated. I'm not a very huge detail planner, but just more of a, I need to have an idea of what scenes I'm doing, what's going to happen to them, and why. Like what Eric was saying, like, see the pants, making decisions on the fly, like, not planning. Oh, and hey, Word, what's up, man? I found that I do better when I know what's going on. And picturing the scene, having a good layout for the plot and the plot in each scene and what I'm trying to do with the scene, its purpose, really helps me. Huh. Yeah, exactly. See the pants. I need to find a middle balance, because I find that if I spend too much time planning, it's almost as bad. Than if I don't plan enough. Thanks for supplying definitions, Word. I appreciate it. Yeah, painting versus architects. Exactly. The writers who just write and it all comes together, and those who have to plan out all the details in order to get the story to work. It's an old expression from, I don't even know what it's from, but it's one of those things that's kind of just been around. Yeah, pop prices, that's pretty much what I'm saying. Like, I don't think I'm particularly great at either, so I need to find a good balance between the two. There is, where did it go? I don't know that one. I was gonna recommend, I like this book a lot. This has helped a lot with my outlining, and the other one that's helped a lot is a book called Write Your Novel in 90 Days, also published by Writer's Digest. I think the 90-day goal was a little unrealistic, but that book really taught me what I want to do with outlines and what I should be trying to do with outlines, especially in terms of scenes and laying out your scenes and that kind of thing. So I really like that book as well. I don't have a copy of it because unfortunately I gave it away to a friend. But yeah. And then using a decent writing tool like Scrivener, where you can kind of lay out all those plot points and expand on them, like the cue card view and all that, really helps me with that kind of thing. Where, you know, I don't have it in this one because I'm on the second draft, but this one, you can put all your like plot points on the cue cards and they only show up on the cue cards, that kind of thing. Nice, Erica. It's an interesting read for sure. I don't buy the whole 90-day thing, but there's a lot of really good points. I learned a lot from reading that book. The one I want to get now is, just because I've been curious about it, is there's one on writing a novel in 15 minutes, like 15 minutes a day sort of thing. And I'm very intrigued by that process. I understand it's gonna take many, many days to do it. Story. Interesting. Oh, I've heard of this, yeah. Well, I come from a screenwriting background, so I've read most of the screenwriting books there are, or a good many of them anyway. So yeah. And I agree with too with that, Wordwin. I study computer programming. I like the logic of iterations and stuff like that. It can be unproductive at times, though. Hey, Silverman. What's going on? Yeah, and for sure, RPGs help a ton. I think any sort of storytelling exercise it will be good for your brain in terms of doing this, in terms of writing, right? How many projects are you actually working on right now, Erica? I'm curious, because I think it's a lot, but I just... This is cool, yeah. Interesting. there's a lot of that kind of stuff with screenwriters. Okay. That's a lot of projects. It's good that they're different, though. And for the record, if you haven't heard me say it before, Scrivener is the best tool for writing graphic novels, period. In fact, that's how I discovered Scrivener in the first place. Was through a comic book called Wasteland. The guy who wrote that actually designed the Scrivener template for doing graphic novels. So yeah. Yeah, for sure. Okay, I can definitely do that. Actually, I can do that right now. That'd be real quick. Just give it a quick overview. New project. So yeah, I just opened up a new comic script. This is the page template. So the interesting thing about comics is there's no standard formatting like there is in film. Film and TV tend to have a very, very standardized format, no matter where you look. Comics don't really have that. That being said, there's a few conventions that tend to be like very consistent. The first being you all start with a page. And then panels are separate breakdowns inside the page. Generally, what you do is you, depending on the format you're using, generally you put how many panels are going to be in the page. Right? But the interesting thing, and the reason that Scrivener is really, really good for doing graphic novels, is these symbols here. See how this says like $N? What this does when you, like let's throw a few more panels in here. God, it's been so long since I did this. Where's my formats? Am I missing something? No. It's been ages since I've done this. Yeah. So you have all your text. So Superman enters from outer space, blah, blah, blah. Like in film, you'd have dialogue like this. Yeah, I can totally do that, CD. That's not a problem. In fact, as a mod, can't you indicate it as a clip? Is that doable? I don't know. I can do it either way. I'm just wondering. I'm entering the planet from outer space. Cool. Sound effects. Sonic Boom. Cool. Anyway. So, when you compile this, and this is the reason that I think it's one of the best things ever. So I'm going to compile this, put in my documents. Test. Okay. Open that up. Documents. Come on. Okay. Sure, no problem, Stevie. I will do it. As everything opens in the wrong window. So you see here, those little symbols are meta tags. So when it populates the script, it does them in the order that they appear and auto populates the number. So you have page one, panel one, two, three, four, five. The reason that this is awesome is because if I created a new page, from template, comic page, go, yay, things are happening, right? When I compile this one, it'll put page two, panel one. But then if I just swap these pages and recompile it, test three, it auto-populates it again, right? So now that page that was page two is now page one is now page two, and it just keeps track of it for you. It's super useful if you want to move things around or if you want to add or take away pages without having to worry about redoing all the little finicky numbers every single time. Super useful for that. It does do the dialogue formatting and all that, like this. That being said, how this appears depends on the final format you're using. For example, Dark Horse has a very specific formatting that they use for all of their scripts. Some of the others are different. Alan Moore's scripts are ridiculously stupid and in all caps, which is the most annoying thing ever. But he loves it. He types entirely in all caps all the time. I don't know why. He just does. It's really, really bad. But yeah. So that's like the main reason why I really, really like this. It makes writing comics a lot easier, especially if you want to move things around. I do want to look, and I don't know if it's possible, but I'd really like to figure out if I can make a macro that would allow me to populate this number along with the other ones based on what's on the page. That'd be really, really awesome. Other than that, I don't know if there's anything else that I should mention with that. Let me check something real quick here. I will link Anthony Johnson's page in here. Anthony Johnson's the writer of Wasteland and the guy who kind of, he made the template. And is the reason I actually bought Scrivener in the first place. Yeah, like he uses weird fonts and stuff. I don't like. I use entirely Courier New, Courier Prime, which is a much easier to read version of Courier New, designed specifically by graphic designers to not look awful when you're reading. For OneNote Silent Willow or for Microsoft Word? Sorry, I'm just scrolling through this article real quick to see if there's anything that I should mention. Yeah, I don't know why my I don't know why it wasn't doing the. Oh, there we go. That's what I wanted. Sorry. And also, if you it doesn't just work for It doesn't just work for the individual pages. Like if you have them separate, you can actually do it inside as well. See? Look, it split them up. But yeah. So that's the main thing. Well, I mean, Courier is the screenwriting font, and I find it super easy to read because it's not a justified font and all that, and it does all that things with that. But yeah, no, I mean if. You wouldn't use Courier for like a final like ebook or something like that. That's what I use because it's easier for me to read and write. And Courier Prime has a Courier Prime has a sans serif version, if I'm not mistaken. I thought it did. Yeah, they do. Boom. So yeah. So other than that, back to Erica's question, when you add illustrations. Unfortunately, Scrivener does not do really, really well with illustrations. That is one of its failing points, in my opinion. Any sort of image file is not really handled well. That being said, I would not use Scrivener to I would not use Scrivener to do a final copy of anything. I would use it to do a draft, and then I would export it into another thing like InDesign or something like that. I'm assuming you're talking specifically because yours isn't necessarily a graphic novel, but more like an illustrated narrative. Something like Stardust or something like that, for example. Correct me if I'm wrong. That's the thing that I think when you talk about that. Yeah, you wouldn't use Scrivener itself to make the comic. You only use it to do the script. Yeah. So for your final, I would probably use something like InDesign, or maybe something like Manga Studio, even Photoshop to a certain extent. Stevie knows a lot more about that stuff than I do, for sure. But yeah, you wouldn't use Scrivener for the final product. You would definitely export it. And I recommend you do that in general for most things. Like, you would export it, and then you would use a more general text editor just to clean it up and make it look nice, sort of thing. But yeah, there you go. It's my tutorial on on writing comics in Scrivener. So I'm just going to make a mental note to highlight this. Or mental note. I'm making a physical note to highlight this. Highlight Scrivener tutorial. Yeah, that would have been my guess as well. Hey 404, what's going on? I teach myself InDesign. I had Drani teach me InDesign once. She was not a happy camper. Yeah. For sure, Ward. For sure. I'm good, man. How are you? Just Drani knows InDesign. Drani is a professional graphic designer, so Drani knows all about InDesign. The thing about it is though, Drani knows all of it in German, and she has trouble teaching me shortcuts because they're all in German. Yeah, the dollar sign ends are tags so that it auto compiles certain values when you write or when you export, I guess. Compile. Words fail me. Words fail me. Oh, yeah, I just had it open. Is it still open here? It is. This is what I was talking about specifically. This is Anthony Johnson, who designed the comics template for Scrivener. I really, really like his comic book, Wasteland. It's really cool. He's a cool guy. And this tutorial specifically is what got me to start using Scrivener. Because I went to his website and found it, sort of thing. All right. I feel like I'm missing something at the end of this scene, but I don't know what else to do. I'll move on to scene four and then I'll come back to it maybe in the next draft. That was weird. Oh, it could be. Right, that makes sense. For those who don't know, I reinstalled my OS and all that, and some of my settings are still off. Yes, apply. Okay, that should be better. I think the fonts are different. Just a little bit. I'm not gonna worry about it too much. It's just weird. Weirds me out. I think that's the problem. We're good. Yeah, that'd be kind of nice, right? I don't really mind it. It's not as bright on my computer. Ooh, whoops. But I understand. There we go. That's better. Turn one was a little just the wrong word. For this project, I've written entirely on PC. In general, I tend to do better when I write on paper. It's one of those things, though, that anything you write on paper, you do have to transfer across. That takes more time. Often I'll mix. I'll do, like, some on paper, then go straight to the PC, put that in, keep writing, print that out, write on paper. Yeah, I print a lot of stuff. I like working with hard copies, for sure. This isn't even the right scene. It depends. It depends. I do a lot of my brainstorming stages directly on paper. I didn't do them for this one, but I have some stuff. I use these a lot when I'm. I use these a lot. These are from that book I was showing earlier. The Writer's Compass. Yeah, I use these a lot just as kind of a get my ideas down on paper. Like, this is like a basic outline with kind of like your main plot points, characters, sort of thing, main goals. So I like that. I do stuff like this a lot. This is for this story here that I'm working on. That thing I just showed Erica, it was a template of an outline from that book I was talking about earlier. I think I have access to it. I have the PDF itself on my computer. Do I have a link to it? I don't know if it's available. I'll put it on my Discord in my file repository. If you guys want it. Spelled that wrong, but that's fine. So that's up there on my file share, my Discord links. Oh, sorry. I gotta adjust my mic settings again. I moved some things. All right, 404. Thanks for hanging out. Yeah. Cheers, man. And there's a link to the Discord. I put the PDF in there. I never use my Discord, though. Very rarely. Oh man, 12:57. Alright, I'm gonna take a 5 minute break. So we're about an hour in. So yeah, I will see you all in a bit.
And we're back. All right. I moved my mic around, so please let me know if it's ridiculously loud or weird or whatever. I think it'll help. I think it'll be better. But it might be way too much gain. Is that better? I think that's better. Good morning. Oh, okay. I thought it was my mic being weird. I was all confused. I was like, but you had no problem earlier. That makes a lot more sense. Stretch. Can I turn that on here? Sorry, I just had a weird thought about something that's been bothering me. about the way this looks on screen. So try to figure out if I can turn that on. Maybe this is what I want. Yes, this is what I want. Awesome. Yeah. So now I should stay in the middle. Perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. Now it should be easier to follow, because then at least it's not gonna like keep going to the bottom of the screen. Makes a lot more sense. Cool. Okay. As usual, I'm totally in my zone, but if you do have any questions or if there's anything you'd like to know, feel free to interrupt me. I'm always happy to answer questions. And I'm also happy to give this disclaimer. So I know people don't like interrupting. But honestly, I'm here to learn just as much as you guys are. So let's have conversations. Oh, yeah, it's on my Discord. So that's the link to my Discord. It's in the file share, which you guys should be able to see. Whoops. Should be there. If it's not, let me know and I will see what can be done. I think I had it on the wrong thing there. Well, I think I had it set up wrong, so that should have fixed it. I'm working on the short story that I started ages ago. The one that I promised I would write only on stream. I've kept that promise. I have. It's been a long road. But it's getting close to completion. I'm hoping that I can finish it between this week and next week. I'm hoping I can get it pretty much close to done. Yeah, that's my plan. That's my plan. Hmm. Alright, so now I have to come up with a better logical process here. And by logical process, I mean I need to figure out how to get Hypernor's mind from point A to point B. Oh, that's an interesting idea. What if Zodnik was the one who made her arm? Hey, what's up? This program is called Scrivener. It's a software designed for writing. No, I don't have a thing for that. Oh, I do. Nightbox just a little behind. Yeah, it's a little different. It's designed to be it's designed so that you can break up your what you're doing into a lot of little pieces and keep them all in kind of one thing so you can work on all of them at the same time. It's very useful. Well, it's much more useful in my opinion than like just a straight word editor. Though there's nothing wrong with just using a word editor. Sometimes it's nice to have that simplicity of just I'm gonna do one thing here, and that's that. I hate using things full screen. I don't like it. I don't like it. Not to mention my full screen actually doesn't fit on the screen properly. Yeah, I don't like it. Interesting. Interesting. I hadn't thought about that, but I suppose it gives you options to customize everything, right? So you'd be able to customize the full screen. I don't like colors. I like black and white, and I like black background, white text. But yeah, maybe that's something I should think about. I don't know. I don't really like full screen, though. I like having the side-by-side too much, a few other things. Trying to consider this. Wait, have I been spelling this wrong the entire time? Oh god. I have been. Oh my god. Whoops. My bad. That's wonderful. Oh, that was pretty bad. amateur hour over here. That's a good one. Yeah, for sure. But I did that. I've been doing that for a while now. So all of the projects I've created since I got this computer in January are on black and white. And I think some of the older ones are too. You can, Erica. I think you gotta use the like project templates and design your project template to have the colors built in that way. Or maybe I'm wrong. Hey, what's up, Disney? does make me curious, though. If I open up something really old. Not that old. Oh, well, that opens pretty much how I want it. Dunno. I don't know. I'm not a big changer. I just I prefer to figure out what works and just leave it, rather than changing it per project. But you know, to each their own. Basically what you do, I haven't done a ton of it, but basically what you do is you set up your options and you hit save as template. I believe Anthony Johnson has a thing on that, on making templates. I read one somewhere about it. Oh yeah, this is where I found out about Courier Prime as well. Cause I hated Courier for a long time. And then I got Courier Prime and now I love Courier. That's all I use. I know there's a good tutorial on it, I'm just not sure where it is. That moment where you realize you've subconsciously been doing everything this other guy on the internet recommended without even thinking about it. He's like, yeah, I don't use this and this and this. It's like, I don't use any of those either. That makes so much sense. You do exactly the same way I do. Anyway. Random. Page 13 of 18. My editing notes here. Making some good progress because I'm not sure we're gonna do the last scene yet. So I don't know if you were, if any of you here were there for the last time I was working on it, but I wasn't sure if the ending I had written was the right ending for the story. It felt very out of place to me. And I've been considering it for quite some time now, and I still haven't come up with a clear answer for what I want the actual ending to be. But yeah, it's one of those things that it's hard to say. I know why it feels weird. I think there needs to be a scene after the one that I'm at. Oh, hey, Johnny. You're not lurking anymore? I saw you sitting there. That's the coolest spelling of Socrates ever. Well, the nerdiest spelling of it, but I don't know. I was making a joke there somehow and failed, which is not that surprising. Not a funny person. Excuse me. Yeah. Oh, hey, Mikel. What's up, man? Oh, boy. It's a stream. It is indeed a stream. I could be wrong now. I've been wrong before. I said you were an expert, but you but you struggle at shortcuts and file menus because you're not used to the English version. Not what I want to say, but is the closest to it that I can think of at the moment, so it's going to stay. Alright, it's just after 2, I'm going to take another quick break, and then come back. Pretty sure we're going to get this scene done today. I always struggle with dialogue, so dialogue's the thing that I kind of get hung up on the most. And then what to put in between dialogue to break it up or make it interesting or, you know. Sometimes I feel like I'm way too logical with it, where it's like, I want to know exactly what everyone's doing, when, and how, and how they're reacting, and the little moments in between, and I don't know. Thinking about it. So yeah, I'm going to take another break. that moment where you realize you forgot to unmute the audio, so music was playing and no one could hear it. Whoops. Oh well. I'm not surprised by that, Johnny. I mean, you melt if you read more than a paragraph, right? But I'm not wrong. Well, not my books. My books are well loved. Centaur. See, the thing is manga and comics are really not all that different. Yeah, I mean, stylistically, they're a little bit different, but it's not as different as you'd think. The types of stories tend to be different. Like, most manga, in general, is about high school students in Japan. Not all the time, but in general. Whereas the vast majority of North American comics tend to be about superheroes. But that's not entirely the case either. There's plenty of good stuff that's not superheroes. For sure. Chiron is not the right person here. I don't know why I put Chiron. Well, that's true, but they have comics for every age group too. I tend to read seinen manga, shonen and seinen most. I don't mind a good shoujo every now and again, but you know, that's a different story. But I also tend to read manga that isn't published in English either. See, I find European comics super fascinating, because I actually have a ton of European comics. I find European comics are either for kids or for adults. They don't have a ton of in-the-middle stuff. I'm not sure, Johnny. Though I suspect it has something to do with your crazy amount of empathy. You can drag lots of things around.
Excuse me.
Yeah, you can't really change the GUI colors from what I've noticed. I don't personally need to. But it is interesting to know. I find that interesting, only because in most cases, visual learners tend to do well through reading. And I'm probably wrong. I mean, if Stevie's still here, she'd probably know more about this stuff than I would. But yeah. because I consider myself to be a fairly visual person. I mean, maybe I'm not that hardcore. Or as hardcore as you, Johnny. But, yeah.
Excuse me.
not sure, Johnny. I've been thinking about that a lot. I might. I think I'm going to try to. It's not going to matter so much later on in the like next year sort of thing. But yeah, we'll see. I have to look at my schedule. The problem, well, I mean, lately my schedule has been all over the place, which is why I just couldn't do it. I wasn't home at the right times and stuff was going on, you know. So we'll see. I hope to, for sure. Ooh. Man. I'm starting to slow down a bit. All of the questions, Johnny. It's Captain America. You can see right there. Just teasing you, Johnny. Rah.
I keep wanting to do it. No, it wasn't. I looked it up. I think it's just the way it's pronounced. It's like Pisinui or something. Anyway. It has a question mark, therefore it's a question. Okay, so I'm going to call it here for today. I am not making much forward progress, not as much as I'd like. Today's been fairly successful, though. Another 700 words done in this draft. And we're nearly done this scene, but it's far enough away that I'm going to call it. But yeah, it's starting to come together. There's still some things I need to figure out. I'd also like to see what it does. I'd like to give it to some people to edit, get feedback on as well. More so than there's just chat feedback, like someone to sit down and read it and actually dig into it. But I'm going to wait until this draft is over. Yeah, I'd like to get this draft done next week, for sure. For sure. Other than that, I love, yeah, exactly. Big fan of the A-Team. This new room setup is awesome. My room does not nearly get as hot as it used to, which is so nice. And I've made a bunch of changes to the website. It's starting to come together. It's not 100% there yet, but it's getting there. So keep an eye out on that. And we'll see how it goes. So any last questions before I head out? Yes, no, maybe. So without further ado, my name is Brendan, and this is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I'll see y'all next week.